Let's now get you the latest from Australia, where the Prime Minister Scott Morrison has apologised for the country's very slow vaccination drive. This comes amid a rise in the Delta variant of coronavirus cases, even as more than half of the country continues to still be under a strict lockdown. Morrison said that he took the responsibility for the sluggish rollout. He added that Australia failed to meet its vaccination target. So far, only 11% of Australians have been fully vaccinated against the infection. And the government's approval ratings continue to drop over its handling of the pandemic.
I take responsibility for the vaccination program. I also take responsibility for the challenges we've had. Obviously, some things within our control, some things that are not. And I'm keen to ensure, as we have been over these many months, that we've been turning this around. I'm certainly sorry that we haven't been able to achieve the marks that we had hoped for at the beginning of this year. Of course I am. But what's more important is that we're totally focused on ensuring that we've been turning this around.
Australia's vaccine drive has been hit by two major issues. It has been administering two vaccines. That is, the one manufactured by AstraZeneca and the other by Pfizer. The AstraZeneca vaccine has been recommended for use only for people above the age of 60 due to some rare blood clotting risks. And the use of the Pfizer jab has also been restricted due to a limited supply. The slow rollout of vaccines comes as the premier of Australia's most populated state, New South Wales, has warned that the virus was spreading like never before. The state reported 124 new cases in the last 24 hours. Authorities have indicated that the state's restrictions will not be lifted soon.
And we can't stress enough how contagious, it's cruel the way this virus is contagious. Any human contact means you can pick up the virus or give the virus. It is spreading like we've never seen before. And I especially want to thank our contact tracers, because if it was not for their efforts, the 124 case numbers today would literally have been in their thousands. And I don't say that lightly.
13 million of Australia's 25 million population is under a lockdown as of now, and apart from New South Wales, Victoria has also imposed a strict lockdown in a bid to curb its cases. The extension of restrictions is frustrating people who have been forced to stay at home. The restrictions have also hurt the Australian economy.
The key. This service terminates at circular key. A light or symbol.
WION World is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news updates on the move.